So let's talk about what happened in MedSurg 1. They say time is money, and I spend most of that with rhyming. I eat filet mignon, reminisce when this was rhyming. Yeah, your chain shining, but my aura is blinding. I'm sick of US currency, I want millions in diamonds. My very first week was very dope. Started off on Tuesday, had an orientation, super dope teacher. I don't know her. Like, my brother had her. I don't know her. And then afterward, is it even? Yeah, it's even. Then afterward on Tuesday, then Monday, I had an instructor who was my clinical teacher. Awesome. Super dope. She's like the best, bro. Like, facts. Facts on everything. Best instructor ever. And like, she's actually my lecture teacher for Wednesday and Thursday, which is dope. So my other teacher, the teacher who gave us our orientation, is Monday and Tuesday. Wednesday and Thursday is this other teacher who was actually my instructor for last year, who was dope. Again, super dope. I have my first exam. My first exam was based on the integumentary. Now that exam, if people's asking, they're like, whoa, you started off on Tuesday, but you got a test on Thursday, like, bro, that's like one day, my G. What? That's like one day for you to really study. And I was like, nah, because, like, I have friends and stuff. I have friends who, like, you know, I tell them, like, yo, I'm starting this, that, I'm starting class here, and then I have a test here, and they're like, that's one day to actually study. But like, no, not really, because that exam was actually a summer assignment. They need to say study review for exam. Well, that's what it said, but according to the thing, it says assignment. So it's like, yeah. But aside from that, they gave a review, a review sheet. It really helped out, but I didn't depend on it. Like, I didn't depend on it at all. Like, the only time when I actually started reviewing it, like, was actually when my teacher, who is my Wednesday and Thursday teacher, told me, like, she started reviewing it. And I was like, you know what? Let me review it. If she's reviewing it, I'm going to review it. If she didn't review it, to be honest, I wouldn't review it. Because, I don't know, I'm the type of person that I'll study everything. I'll study everything. Everything. Back to back. And stuff like that. If I even have time, I'll study the values. So, which sometimes you really need to know the values. Like, probably values is really important when you're dealing with electrolytes. Values important with electrolytes. Values important with labs and stuff like that. But for integumentary, no, not really. But aside from that, let's go over my exam, my G. Let's go over my exam. My exam, but what showed up. And again, this video is not a cheap video. This is a review video. This is a review video for you guys. Again, my instructor and your instructor is not the same. My school and your school is not the same. We might not be in the same program. I'm in the LPN. You might be in the RN program. FYI, the LPN, RN, MedSurg, fundamentals, all that, blah, blah. All the nursing, like, the main ones are all basically the same. Like, facts. It's all the same. The only thing is with nursing, with an RN, you're more emphasizing with drugs. And you're more, yeah, mainly drugs and delegating. That's it. But aside from that, the whole med search part, like, maternity, psych, all that, the same. Like, actually, there's one review class in New York. It's called Helen Fuhr, one of the best schools, one of the best review schools. The person who recommended that place was actually my mom, and my mom actually attended the first Helen Fuhr when it was owned by the original owner, and this was like in the 90s when my mom first came here from the States, from the Philippines to the States. And when she was here, you know, that was the shortage of nurses. She's Filipino. You have a time frame to pass the board exam. And she attended it, and she passed it on the first run. So, later on, like, you know, my brother took the LPN program and decided to do a review, and my mom recommended that place, and legit, he passed it on the first try. That's cool, but, you know, it's not the same instructor, of course, because this is, like, a couple years later. But, how many years later? A lot. Probably over 20 years. That school is dope, man. But he did the review, and he told me off right, but, like, yo, when I did the review, I was with RN students. I was, like, with them, and they were reviewing all together. And it was the same material. The only thing that they told him, like, you don't need to attend. But actually the pharmacology aspect, aside from that, pharmacology and leadership. But, like, back to the inventory. What showed up was, let's see, what showed up is the layers of the epidermis. Epidermis, dermis, that showed up, and that's really important. You should know this by now. You're a med surg, you pass AMP, and the basic concept part of that, you should already know. the dermis is the protective layer. The epidermis is the protective layer, and the dermis is really, like, what nutrients the epidermis, because that's where all the blood supplies and all that stuff all there. And of course, under it, there's the hypodermis, which is below the dermis, because, you know, hypodermis, below the dermis. And that's where all your fatty tissues, subcutaneous, adipose, and all that stuff, it's all up in there, too. Now, in this book, the book that I'm actually, that I'm using is Understanding Medical Surgical Nursing, 5th edition, by Williams and Hopper. Now, in this book, it went into detail with hair, nails, glands, vessels, and stuff like that. That didn't show up, but this is basic AMP concept that you should just know. Well, I'm not going to go over it, because, you know, but you should know that. A couple of things, too, that, you know, the glands and stuff. One thing that plays an important role with this is actually the sebaceous gland. Sebaceous gland kicks in a lot, because sebaceous glands, oily, this and that, there's dermatitis and stuff like that. It sounds like diarrhea. Well, basically, it's a diarrhea of the cirrhosis. Sebacearia, or whatever, sebacearia dermatitis, which is the overproduction of the sebaceous glands secreting sebaceous secretions, oily skins and stuff like that. So sebaceous stuff really plays an important role. But when it comes down to old people, the sebaceous and the sweat glands are something that you should know, because if you don't know if you don't understand their function, you don't, like say if you get all the applies, you wouldn't know, like, what does that do? Well, that regulate, that moisturizes skin. Aside from that, it keeps the skin from cracking because it moisturizes it. Aside from that, it also controls, like, your temperature and stuff. Like, old people, let's say, their temp isn't stable because their glands aren't working. But, yeah, that showed up. You should already know how a physical assessment works. You pass fundamental, I'm not gonna go over that. You should know the aging process, everything goes down. You should know that. In this exam, really, what was emphasized more was burns. A lot of the burns showed up. You should know the concept, the coloring. The coloring is important. Erythema is redness. Pallor is lack of color, paleness. Jaundice is yellowish. And cyanosis is bluish coloration. Now, when it comes down to the lesions and the primary and secondary lesions that showed up. But what was more emphasized in my exam, what showed up was more the primary. The primary stuff showed up a lot. And the way that came out was, what's that called? Match, cross match, where you match it out. And it was dope, but yeah, because it was dope. It's just. You know what, it may look like a lot of things, but if you're able to just break things down to to a way where you could just remember it and store it into the long-term memory, you're good to go. And the way I do stuff like that is I break it down into its really simple form. Because if you take a big chunk of stuff, like let's say you stuff your pocket. If you're like consistently putting things in your pocket, there's one point where it's just going to be full and it'll crack. And like your pocket will just break open. Or a bag. I don't know. But like say a bag and you're just stuffing things, it's going to break open. You can't put nothing else into it. So it's just that. But the primary lesions came out. Secondary lesion came out. Primary lesion compared to the secondary lesion. A primary lesion is caused by a disease. Secondary is caused by trauma. And stuff like that. Then afterward, later on, when it comes down to this, you really need to know the different, like, what makes things different with the primary thing, because there was a cross match, and there was one point where I was actually panicky, where I was like, holy wow, I have to do cross match, and yeah, like, once when you know the difference, you're good to go. If you know the difference of what separates this and that, you're good to go, and I'm going to go over it, which will hopefully help you guys. Macula is flat and color. Well, when I think of macula, I think of flat and color. Flat and color. When I'm thinking of papule, I'm thinking of it's a papule. It's like a lesion. It's elevated, and it's less than 1 centimeter. When it comes down to nodule, or whatever, that one. The way I remember that is, I think of it the same thing as papule, except it's just a larger and deeper version. Vesicle, the way I remember vesicle is the serous fluid. Hold up, serous fluid, vesicle. Bella, when I think of a bola, I call it bola. I've been calling it Bella. Like me, I'll be like, listen, it's easier for me to just remember Bella, but it's bola. It's B-U-L-L-A. When I think of that, I think of a blister. Pustule, common sense. What's inside it? A pus. A wheel, when I think of wheel, I'm thinking a bite. And the key word for that, the way I remember it, is capillary. When there's like a dilation, because it's like, you know. Plaque is a patch. Cyst is, it's just a sac. Now, a lot of people actually confuse cyst and a pus, because they're like, well, you know what? A pus and a cyst, well, for other people, it has like a pustule and a cyst is basically the same thing. It's a sac and a half. No, bro. Because the way I remember it is a cyst is a wall. It's a patch. It has a defined wall. It's a pouch. That one. And then afterward, when it comes down to secondary stuff, secondary is really like, it's not difficult for you to remember. Like scale, dry, because, you know, I think of an alligator. Crest. Think of a scab. Fissure, I think of a crack. Ulcer, we already know what ulcer. Luteal ramification, it's a thickening. I think of that. It's bad because the way I remember that word, I can't even pronounce it, but I think of a chubby leprechaun. For me, I look at it, it looks like leprechaun to me. I know it don't look like leprechaun, but in my head, it's like, huh. Chubby leprechaun, itchy, thick, hard, chubby leprechaun. I don't know if it makes sense for other people, but then afterward, later on, like here, it goes into stuff like moisture, dryness, edema, stuff like that. Those things really didn't show up, but what showed up is the vascular stuff. The vascular stuff came out, petechia and erosomosis. I can't pronounce words, FYI. Petechia is purple dots and the like little spots and stuff like that. And the ecchymosis is like basically a bruise. That showed up. Then the next part came up. This stuff didn't really show up. culture stuff showed up. Know about culture stuff. Know about biopsy. Understand the concept of a biopsy. Why and stuff like that. One thing I showed up to is the Woods Light examination. Know that. This is because I'm going to go over 3 chapters, so I'm not going to break down word by word, but I'm just going to tell you, but like, what you should just be like, boom. Which technically all of it, but emphasize on this area. Wound dressing stuff. Yeah. Focus on that. The bath. Yes, very yes. When it comes down to topical stuff, yes, no topical stuff. The dressing, yes. The common dressing on this book, there's a lot of common dressing. Listen to your instructor, whatever your instructor says. Because sometimes there's some instructor where they want you to memorize everything. I came from a school in New Jersey, but they wanted us to memorize everything. And it was like, it was overwhelming. It was overwhelming, but at the time when you go to clinical, let's be serious, you're not even going to be dealing with that. But when it comes down to dressing, one thing that you really need to know is the duoderm. Duoderm is something that you need to know. You need to know duoderm. Duoderm is actually favorable when you're dealing with a stage 2 infectious with drainage. That one, which, you know, you change often because you don't want infection and there's drainage and stuff like that. So duoderm, remember that. Remember that. Stage 2, duoderm. Stage 2, duoderm. Stage 2, duoderm. Stage 2, duoderm. Know that. Duoderm. Aside from that, too, the algae. The algae is really a popular thing that a lot of people like to, like, in the NCLEX, because I do NCLEX review questions, they talk about the algae one. Seaweed, alginate, or whatever. That one shows up a lot. Know the difference between an open and closed dressing. And then this is the closing of this chapter. Then afterward, chapter 54, which is the caring of skin disorder. This showed up. Now let's talk about what showed up. Pressure ulcer. You should already know that this is going to show up. Pressure ulcer is a must. You just need to know that. Pressure ulcer is one of Ursher. I know my lisp is like all over the place, but pressure ulcer is important. You should know the nursing intervention for pressure ulcer. You should know the assessment. How to do assessment with a pressure ulcer. Yeah, you should know that one. When it comes down to pressure ulcer, that's why you need to know the wound dressing. Know what a negative pressure, negative pressure wound therapy is. Know what that is. Which is an awesome thing. What's it for? Which is, you know, it promotes healing and it takes out drainage. It promotes healing because the negative pressure actually promotes blood circulation. Blood circulation is an awesome thing. Keep it going. Keep it moving. Yeah, staging. You should know dermatitis. A lot of people get confused with dermatitis and cellulitis. They just think dermatitis is infecting the skin and cellulitis is the skin and the cells and stuff like that. No, the dermatitis is inflammation. I mean, people think both of them are both inflammation. Dermatitis is inflammation. Cellulitis is inflammation in regard to infection. Know that 3, that's an important thing. When it comes down to that, you should know the 3 most common dermatitis, which is contact, which is allergen, like, you know, like soap and stuff like that, poison ivy, atopic, it's more like hereditary, things passed down to you, allergic reaction, stuff like that. Then afterward, oh, here we go. Soroboraca. I don't know. But it's just inflammation of the skin in regards to overproduction of sebaceous secretion from the sebaceous gland. You should know the basic terminology, at least know what Pruritus is itchiness, that's what it is. Just a fancy word of saying itchiness. You should know the nursing intervention for treatment for a pruritus, which is basically three main things. Anesthesia, which is for pain. Antihistamine, which is a lot of time for itchiness or inflammation, stuff like that. And the third one is antipyretic. Why not? You should know that. If you don't know that, bro, you need to pay attention to your terminology, my friend. Then it goes into cirrhosis. When cirrhosis came out, the best way to remember cirrhosis is Kim Kardashian. And it was dope because my teacher who was giving us the review, she's dope. I hope she'll remember things very easy. Like the way she's able to teach things in a way where you can recall it without twisting your arm. When you think of cirrhosis, you think of Kim Kardashian. She actually has that. Which is, and the thing is with cirrhosis, it is, the cause is unknown. And since the cause is unknown, it's categorized as, people just say, but like, oh, it's autoimmune. So, cirrhosis, autoimmune, which is like, you know, the flag sign for it is silver scale, a ding ding. That is a big ding ding, like ding ding, you should know it. But instead, what is a key, like what's a characteristic that you see it, like yo, silver scale, cirrhosis. Keep it moving. And of course, like the treatment stuff, you should know the treatment because it deals with the skin. Vitamin D, sometimes it's itchy. So like, you know, it's based on systemic stuff. I mean, the systemic, symptomatic treatment. There we go. Boom, boom, boom. One thing with cirrhosis too that you should know, because there's some things that's like a little bit more common sense, but one thing with that is the UV rays actually helps it. So that's one thing to remember. It'd be like, you see that? That's definitely one of the things. Then afterward, later on, it goes into herpes, infectious skin disorders. Herpes, yes, you should know the difference between the 1 and 2. 1 is above waist, 2 is below. You should know... let's see... You should know how it's being spread, contact. You should know when it's really infectious, when it's open. You should know when it's not infectious, when it crosses up. You should know the tingly feeling before you get it. I mean, you should know the feeling that you get, a patient gets when they get it, which is like a tingly or itchy or burny feeling on the area or moving to the site or on the site. That showed up. Shingles showed up. You should know who's at risk. Stressed out people. And when I'm talking about stress, it could be emotional. It could be physical. Well, not really emotional. It can be emotional. Because when you're emotional, you're releasing stress. And when you feel stress, you're releasing cortisone. And when you're leaving cortisone, you're releasing... when you have cortisone in your body, it will suppress your immune system. So when people say stress will kill you, stress can kill you, my G. Like, facts. Like, stress will kill you. Like, stress can kill you. It will give you hypertension, this, that. But aside from that, too, like, it will weaken your immune system. You will get more sick if you are stressed out. So just chill out, relax, and calm down. Do whatever you need to do to just chill. But... shingles is one of those things where the people that's at risk is weak. Like the people is like weak because the immune compromise, like, you know, mainly AIDS, stuff like that. Who's in immune suppressant therapy. Like that. Like and people usually go on immune suppressants therapy because her autoimmune is kicking in, so they're trying to remove the cells, and it gets more complicated. But, boom, it's stress. Key thing is stress. Think of what stresses you, and that is a factor. That is a huge factor. Because that's the time when the body goes, it's our time. It's more of an opportunistic. It's like a person, it's like a virus that takes advantage of the situation. Same thing with the hepatitis, herpes. Herpes takes advantage. When your body feels weak, you'll have an outbreak. That's why people usually get outbreak on the winter time. Like, people call it, oh, it's a cold sore, it's nothing. No, it's not just a cold sore. You got herpes, my G. Stop being in denial. But the reality is, the person has herpes. It's called cold sore because it shows up in wintertime. And the reason why it comes out in the wintertime is because your body is stressed. And when your body is stressed, again, your body produces cortisol. And cortisol is a steroid. And steroid messes up your immune system. That's why people get sick in the wintertime with the flu. Because it's not like... The flu is all year round. It's all over the place. You could get the flu in the summertime. But a lot of people get it on the wintertime because their immune system is weak due to the stress produced by their body. Well, stress from outside, and the body produces cortisol. And cortisol suppresses your immune and that. By the time when you finish this whole video, you're going to be like, steroid, immune compromise. Not immune compromise, but your immune system is weakened. Like that, you're going to be good to go when you come to endocrine. You'll remember that. That's one thing that you need to know. What does steroids do? Cortisol in your body does. But continuing on, then afterward, it moves into the fungi infection. You know, the main thing is the athlete's foot. The thing with the athlete's foot is, when you're dealing with the athlete's foot, you're dealing with a person who is, like, his feet is always moist. Either diaphoresis of the foot because they're sweaty. That's why you tell them, be like, yo, wear some socks, my G. Dry socks. That's why people who don't wear socks are more prone to get athlete's foot, because their foot is enclosed in a small area and it's nice, moist, and that is where a lot of fungus and bacteria like to grow. Dry and moist. And warm. And cool. Well, some bacteria likes in the cool, some bacteria like in the cold. So it depends. But more dark and moist. Moist place, dark place, no bueno. But fungi, know that one. Know what athlete foot is. Know what a ringworm in a scalp is. Know what a thrush is. That's one thing you should know. Well, actually, thrush should have been one of those things that you should have known when you were doing fundamental. Because I don't know if you're doing your clinical, you're administering medication, but you should be able to do head-to-toe assessment and thrush when you see the tongue all covered up in white stuff. More likely thrush, like really thick. We're not talking about I just drank milk and my tongue is white. We're talking about thick film, white, and they have a certain smell to it. Thrush, and that's a overproduction of, it's basically a yeast infection in your mouth. Candidiasis or whatever, it's an overprotection of, like, it's a yeast infection. Keep it moving. Know what acne is. We all had acne. Know what causes it and what don't cause it. Know the difference between black and a white hair. The nursing intervention. When you're teaching a patient, nursing teaching to a patient, dealing with that. Wash your hands, don't touch your face too much. I wash my hands, so I touch my face a lot. Keep it moving. Parasite stuff, know about parasite stuff. At least know the terminology and stuff like that. That, know about lice and stuff, know about scabies, know about that. Let's see. Pegarufafel or whatever that is. Know about Pegarufafel or whatever. I think of Pegasus. Most of the time when I can't pronounce the word, I think of a word that kind of looks like it or looks like it in my head. Like me, I'm Filipino. I'm like, it's not even me being Filipino. I'm Balul. Balul is a person who can't pronounce certain words. Well, in my language, Balul. It's like they say certain word but they can't say. Like I legit can't say Pepto Bismol. If I say, I have to say it really slowly. Like Pepto Bismol. Pepto Bismol. Even when I say it like that, it sounds weird. I can't say it. But if I say it like I want to say it just regularly, I'll just say it like Pepto Bismol. I don't know. But I think of it like that. Pegasus or whatever. That is also an autoimmune. Know that. That is one thing that... That's one of those things that you should know. Well, think of bili. It's like blistering all over your body. Know that it can get painful because the blister actually hardens up. Then after it falls off. It's what happens is the epidermis legit forms a blister. Separates from the epidermis. And then when that separates, you know, that's going to dry up. Like a blister. Right now how a blister is? It'll dry up and so it'll fall off. And when it falls off, your epidermis is going to be really exposed. And the thing with that is, you got to think about the epidermis. Your first layer of defense is gone, so your infection's not there. You're at risk for infection, my bad. But the thing that people actually complain more about is the pain. Because of the fact that there's like your nervous out in the open. Like, yo, what up, my G? I'm here to party and mess things up. Make your life miserable. Keep it moving. Let's keep it moving. Then after all, skin cancer, you should know about skin cancer. There's a lot of things. Here's one thing, keloid. Now, this wasn't in my review. It wasn't my review thing. But I reviewed it, and I told people, like, yo, don't just study that. If you just study that, my G, I don't know. Keloid is, it's more of a, like, a scar formation regard to a surgical incision, and it's more common with the African American people. Well, it says over here dark colored patient, but like, you know, more common with them. Know about you, you should know that one. When you're dealing with that, you're dealing with like, you know, therapy and stuff. You should know nursing. Now, burns showed up a lot. Like, facts. It was all over the place. Burns was like, I focused on 54, which is the disorders, a lot. Because I was like, I need to know this. And like, I need to know it. Like, holy crap, I need to know it. But what showed up a lot was burns. And burns, I was... Check my method, man, bring a Susan. Haters, we leave them oozing. Headed to the top, penthouse where we moving. Ha! Bless the mic with my presence in and I teach ya. Listen carefully as I beseech ya. If I never meet ya, I hope my lyrics reach ya.